Welcome to Barcombe Mills. It's a beautiful place. And I've just seen the photographs that I've just taken over near that bridge just over there. And now we've come over this way. There's a little birdie down there. I'm going to come along here, and I've just spotted this over here. I'm going to see if I can get a couple of pictures over there. And slow the images down so the water looks nice and soft and smooth around there. But the light here at the moment is lovely as it comes through those trees. It's beautiful. So, yeah, we'll go there and crack on. What a beautiful scene. Absolutely amazing. So the last time I came here, I noticed that these pillboxes were here, and pretty overgrown. I think they're a type 24 pillbox. The doors have been bricked up, which is a bit of a shame, so I can't get in. But I can look in through the windows, and there's several around, obviously. So I've got my torch. We're going to have a look. Let's see what we can find. Not much in there. Just give you the general shape of the inside, really. I think we've been in there. They were open at some point, but pictures online show that the door was actually opened. But, yeah, these are bricked. There's a fair amount of water inside as well. I don't know if you can see that down the bottom there, but water down there. I know this area is prone to flooding, so maybe that's where that's come from. And there's another one. There's another one actually a bit further down. We're gonna keep walking down that way and see what adventures we can find. Take a few more photographs. And just look at this beautiful late autumn place. It's gorgeous. Love it. But yeah, there is another one further down. Just around the corner, and I think the last time I looked around it, there was a discarded tent. There's all kinds of stuff inside that snuck up, something crawled in and died in there. So, quite a pleasant experience. There's a nice breeze coming from that direction now. You can see the ripples in the water. That's just where I was around there. Where I've come from there. So this is the second one. This is. The ground must have built up over it because the doorways are quite low. And I walk right up to now, it's kind of below my shoulder level. I know this area is prone to flooding, so silt was probably built up over time. You can see that old concrete roofs, the old ballast. Another hole, you can look in there. That's stupid graffiti. There's a barbecue in there. Rubbish. Definitely keep it up. Don't want to be in there. Go around. So that's the tent I found. At some point someone's stayed the night, but if it didn't have so much crap inside of it, I'd probably salvage it, but he's at it. There's a big rip down one side anyway. Yeah. Things that people leave behind amazes me. There's the corner again. It's the other window, the keep out bit that you've just seen. Awesome places though. I've got a little bit of info about this, so I'll flash it up. I'll put it in the description below. You can have a read about Barcombe Mills. I can't go around there any further. We've got a stream down here. It's lovely. It runs a quarter around that way. Once again, rubbish. It's like someone's staying here a while then. There's toothpaste here. Kinds of junk. And they're the pillboxes. Type 23 or 24. I can't remember now. But yeah. It's pretty awesome. A lot of ivy's growing on these. Beautiful place.
You should be frightened by this problem. I expect it to end in 10. Throw money at the problem, it comes right back again. Throw armies at the problem, it's just wars we can't outwin. Throw religions at the problem, still we are destined to sin. Throw TV cameras at the problem, everybody tune in at 10. Throw new products at the problem, they wind up in bargain bin. Throw equality at the problem, throw lawyers at the problem, throw education at the problem,
school roofs should have came in.
Throw values at the problem,
everybody has their own opinion. When I broached the subject, did I mention to me at 10?
Sussex Way footpath or something like that. That's where I've just come from over there. It's Mr. Tractor Man. I don't know what this is here, this is like a shed. You can walk over, have a look down. It's quite bright that way. But stunning waterways. Not a lot of this exists down in Brighton, or I say Brighton, but I'm actually on the Sussex, so gorgeous nonetheless. So we come out at the end, the path continues back along that way. I guess it just follows the river, and then I think what it does is it cuts across and then over, and then you walk down the road. I think it's a road over there. You follow the road back down to the house that's down there. And I know there's a goose farm over there. What I'm trying to look for now is a little place just to pitch my tarp up and grab something to eat. Grab a brew. I'm a tad thirsty. It's a question of finding somewhere. And there's a few people around, it's quite busy. and I've made my way around to Barcombe as well. I'm somewhere about here. I'd like to follow it up a little bit longer, and that should be up to where it says sluices there, which is in that direction over there. But I have to go, I have to follow. I have to follow this route up here. I could come across where I am now, but I get cut off by the river here and over here, so I need to follow back along here and then back up towards sluices, and that's near the anchor in. I'm not actually far from Platcher Wood, which is just up here where I was originally going to go, but I've been wanting to photograph this place for a while now, so we'll have to see what goes on. I'm going to grab a cup of tea and then see what the time is.
So, I'm not alone. I've got some, I don't know, navvies or whatever they call themselves over there. This is where I've just set up. No time for a bit to harp, I'm afraid. Well, not so much time, it's just that I've never really put it. I'm sitting underneath this beautiful oak tree, which is grand. It's lovely. Reservoir is literally straight up there. Where those guys are working up there, I think they're clearing a load of old grass and green waste. That's where I've come from, straight down through the middle there. And the rest of the Sussex path is a long lap way to the right side of the where it meets the tree, which is quite nice there. I think what I'm going to do is just sit here while I have a bit of time and just relax. I was hoping for a bit of wildlife in the water here, but there's been nothing so far. These rivers do produce pike, trout, and I've been told salmon as well. Sea salmon, is it salmon? I think it's sea salmon. When it comes up, they swim upstream to the river up here. But I got caught talking to an old guy. There was an old guy down much further down near the start, and he was saying that there's normally salmon and trout down here, but he hasn't seen any. So, unfortunately, I probably won't either. But I'm not really a fisherman, it's just nice to see.
Time is a killer, you can never have enough. And take what you're given, always be enough. Indecision will always hold you down. And your mind will prevent you from coming around. gotta kick the can. Don't be lazy, I'm never trusting you. And mind your manners, it's the only thing to do. Indecision will always hold you down. And your mind will prevent you from coming around. And don't be spacey, you can't have maybe. I'm beginning to learn, beginning to trust someone. And don't be spacey,
I'm
I've gotta kick
way.
The can.
Investigating that one there. See
what
goes.
Gotta kick the can. Gotta kick the can. Gotta kick the can.
Well, this is the other building that I saw across from the other side. Now, what I thought was a pillbox isn't actually a pillbox. Just some random building, I guess. Pump house maybe.
It looks like we made it.
Hi.
There's a way for us to go. It's half a beginning, I thought you should know. Now dot the I's, if you cross the T's. Now dot my I's, cross my T's. The sun never looked up and shine so bright.
I like fake. I forget to check the actual channel.
It was never as easy to fall in love that night.
One more than I'm
you dyed my
eyes. Thanks for watching. See you
cross
on the next video.
My teeth. The way you dyed my eyes. Oh, what a thank you. for how I marvel at all the things that I can't understand. And oh, how I marvel at all the things that I won't understand.